Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to another video about using DaVinci Resolve as your editor. This time I'll show you how to do an animation effect on a map. This effect I have done previously in After Effects when we did our documentary about Klaus Wunderlich. But today I want to show you how to do that inside of Resolve. So without further ado, let's go to the edit suite. Here we are back, not in DaVinci Resolve, but this time in GIMP. You can also use Photoshop. All you need to do is you need to have some kind of manipulation photo software. So let's start off by using the pen tool. And with the pen tool, we'll just draw the path of the line we're going to make. Okay, with that being done, let's go up to Edit. And let's go down in Path or Stroke Path. And here we can change the various settings. So let's make this a little less, and let's click the line style and then just go down and choose whatever we want. Let's take this one and just let's go do like that, stroke that. Okay, and that's all you have to do, more or less, than save it as a JPEG and take it into DaVinci Resolve. Okay, and here we are in DaVinci Resolve. So let's just drag the map we did. And of course you also need to have a clean plate without the lines to make this work. So, and then you put them in the timeline with the line on the top layer. Let's go to the color tab. And in the color tab, we will just go to the window and we'll just do a quick basic square. And then right click and then add alpha output and drag that to the blue dot. Drag this out. And as you'll see, it has now disappeared. Then we need to go out to the keyframes. And in the keyframes, you need to set a keyframe in the power curve. Just let move a bit and it will set the first keyframe and let it go to the end and then just drag that. So now we've done the basic animation pretty fast. So let's take this airplane as well and let's use that. Let's choose that, go up to the inspector and just let's scale that down a bit. Okay, and change the position. Let's move it over here and let's do like some basic here. And okay, let's do something with the rotation angle so it will fit kind of to the line. Okay, a little with the position again. Okay, and then let's go to the beginning of the clip, go back and then check this, the top marker, so it'll set a keyframe for all the, for everything. And then just let's start moving it a bit. Going up there, and let's. So the trick is to make the back end of the plane hit the red lines, so it will go, or so it will follow that kind of. So let's just continue on that. And again, position forward. Let's see. Let's do a little of the rotation as well. And continue a bit. And I'm doing this pretty fast because it's, otherwise it'll be a very long tutorial. You can go crazy with this and do it very precise, but for the sake of the tutorial, let's just do it a bit fast, okay? And again, let's do that. And let's see. Let's go to the end. And okay. And do something with the position and then the rotation again. And then move it a bit back. Okay. So now we have, like, this is the basic animation. Done pretty fast, and of course you can do it more precise than I did. But let's make some kind of camera movement on this clip. So let's highlight the clip, right click, and then go up and do a new compound clip. And let's call this map. and create that. So now we have that. Then click it and then go to the inspector. And then let's just use the dynamic zoom. And then just swap that, so go towards the plane. So now we have already made this a little more alive by doing something very simple. So, but let's continue. Let's make it look like an old cartoon or something. So here I have some old overlay, and I'll just click that and then change the composite mode to screen. And then we can make it more visible, but let's keep it on 100. I think that'll be just fine. So we have these old lines. Let's do a little bit more. Let's go to timeline and then go down to output blanking. And then let's do 2.40. So we have these white screen bars. Looking nice. Let's do a bit of sound as well. And let's say, okay, let's just do it very fast. And that's for the sake of the tutorial, a little short. Okay, let's do a little more. Let's drag some film grain onto the clip as well. And you can do that from the editor now, so that's very cool. And then just go to the inspector and go to open effects, and let's take like 8mm or something, yeah. And let's play with the opacity and the texture as well. And yeah, let's do something with the size of the grain. There we are. Softness. So you can see here, let's toggle it off and on. So it does something, it looks more filmic, more grainy. And here we have the animation. So I hope you found this useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think they'll might find it helpful. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep learning and keep sharing.